Good morning, students. How are you? Hope that you all are well at home. Now it's time to revise our third chapter, Hello Universe. In this chapter, we have learned about understanding the solar system, components of the solar system, stars and constellations. You know, students, our universe is made up of stars, moons, planets, galaxies, and many other heavenly bodies. The name of our galaxy is called the Milky Way. What is a solar system? The sun and its family of 8 planets and pieces of rocks and dust together form the solar system. The 8 planets in our solar system are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Next point is the sun. The sun gives us warmth, light, and energy. It is a huge ball of hot gases. The energy we get from the sun is called the solar energy. The sun is a star, you know. Which star is 20 times brighter than the sun? Yes, the answer is Sirius. Mercury is the closest planet and Neptune is the farthest planet to the sun. Now, we can group planets in two simple ways. By composition, by size. By composition, planets are divided into two. Rocky planets and gaseous planets. By size, planets are divided into small planets and giant planets. Next point is Earth's moon. Some planets have one or many smaller companions called satellites. Our planet has only one satellite called the moon. Earth's moon is a heavenly body that orbits the Earth in 28 days. Jupiter has the most number of satellites. Now, stars and constellations. Stars produce heat, light, ultraviolet rays, and are made up of gases. The bright star we see in the sky is called pole star. Now, what are constellations? Constellations are a collection of bright stars which form patterns in the sky. Ursa Major and Saptarshi are the two examples of the constellations. In the next class, that is on this Saturday, 20th of June, we will have a test on this chapter. So, prepare well.